Hey guys, welcome back. I know this is not my upload day. I wanted to throw this bonus video up for you because I have been seeing this all over my DMs, all over my emails, all over everything. People are like, you have to try this. And I'm like, okay, I have some issues with it though, so we're gonna figure it out together. I am gonna do two dips into Scarlet by Revel Nail, just like a French pink color. Got that dipped, got it filed, got it everything. If you want to know how I do dip, if you're new here, hi, I'll leave a video for you down in the description box on like my start to finish process. Very beginner friendly. But I've got my stamper, I've got some stuff, and we're going to work this out together because while it looks like a great idea, I had concerns. I had a couple of concerns. I'm like, I'm going to break my stamper, I'm going to get product everywhere. So I figured, let me try it with a few different things because with gel, a lot of people have gel allergies and can't use gel. So we're gonna try it with gel polish, with regular nail polish, and with acrylic paint, and we're gonna shake it all out together. So the first one I'm gonna do is with gel polish. This is White Addict by Nail Addict LA. I'm trying to give everything as fair of a shot as possible. I'm just gonna roll this in my hands, get it nicely mixed. You don't wanna shake up polish because that can cause air bubbles. And I'm gonna paint it right on the thing. And I didn't see a lot of videos of people actually painting this on the stamper. I'm like, how much? I don't know, is this enough? But I got it on there. It looked like a pretty consistent layer on the jelly stamper. And now I'm gonna take my nail and press it into the jelly stamper, and you go super slow. You can see as it goes into the stamper what angle or curve that smile line will have, and you can adjust it slowly, and then it looks like it worked. It absolutely worked. But here's the thing, there is now gel polish all over my skin, all up underneath my nail. This is going to be a cleanup process, and this can cause gel allergies. So I'm going to say, please don't do this with gel polish. I beg of you, please don't do it with gel polish. I'm gonna go ahead and get this cleaned up. I panicked and grabbed like all of my cleanup supplies. I don't have gel allergies, thankfully, that I'm aware of, but I really don't want them. So it was a rush to get this as clean as possible, as soon as possible. Now that I've gotten it all cleaned up for the most part, we're gonna move on and we're gonna try this with regular nail polish. So I'm gonna do the same thing with my regular polish. I'm gonna give it a good roll in my hands and paint that on my jelly stamper. And we're gonna try this again on a different nail. And I wanted to do three different nails with three different products so you can see the difference. And y'all are gonna see which one the clear winner is. But polish. Okay, so we're getting on the regular nail polish and I'm gonna do the same exact thing. Press my nail right into that jelly stamper. And seemingly, this one works too. The only issue I had with the regular polish is it dries super quick and it already started getting gummy. It wasn't very consistent, like the curve wasn't very consistent. The corners didn't want to take for some reason. So this one is fine. It works. If you have regular nail polish, you want to try it, it will work. You may have to do more than one coat on the nail to get your smile line super consistent. And also a ton of cleanup because again, there is polish all over my skin, all up underneath my nail, and the only way to remove that is with acetone. Is it doable? 100%, absolutely doable, which you're gonna see me do right here a little bit. But acetone also very much dries out your skin, dries out your nails, dries out your cuticle area. Not that this is on your cuticle area, but you get what I'm saying. It's gonna dehydrate your skin and nails and can cause also contact dermatitis. Now we're gonna try it with acrylic paint, which is one of my go-tos for any type of nail art. I blopped it on the stamper. I'm gonna spread it around with just a basic brush and we're gonna see how this one works. And spoiler alert, acrylic paint wins the whole thing. Wins the whole thing. I couldn't believe how perfect this looked with the acrylic paint. And I'm gonna show you how to do it a couple of times. I'm gonna show you how I top coated it, how I cleaned it off. Super, super easy. Same thing, pressing it into the stamper. Look how clean and white that looks. Super consistent. Yes, it is all over the place. It is up underneath my nail. It is on my sidewalls. But, and I'm going to show you this on my pinky as well. Eventually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off the gel and the polish one. And I'm going to do all my nails with the acrylic paint because I loved it so much. And I'm going to top coat this after it dries, of course. But I'm not going to clean anything up. Acrylic paint's not going to hurt my skin at all. And it's, you know, washable with water. So I'm going to let this dry completely with it being a total mess everywhere. And once it's dry, I'm going to top coat. I'm going to pay very close attention to make sure I cover that entire edge. I'm not capping my edge because I never cap my edge, but I'm going to cover the sides and the tip very, very well with top coat. Then once that's cured, because I'm using gel top coat, you could use regular dip top coat or polish top coat. I'm using gel top coat. Once that's cured, I'm going to go wash my hands and scrub the crap out of them. And it all comes off. It all comes off. Zero mess anywhere. You're gonna see. Okay, so I'm gonna finish up stamping the rest of my nails, and I'm gonna come back for my final thoughts as if you didn't already. The acrylic paint dry for about 5 to 10 minutes, top coated, scrubbed my hands, and they could not look more perfect. This is probably, and I've done a lot of French manis with everything, with gel, with dip, I've done it all. But this is by far the most perfect French I have ever done, and I will be doing French manis like this from now until the end of eternity. So whoever came up with this TikTok trend, thank you. Thank you for your contribution, because you have changed my nail game. 100%. And I hope that you guys will try this too. And if you do, let me know your thoughts, tag me in photos. Thank you guys so much for hanging out, even on my day off. I will catch y'all in the next one. Love you. Bye.